It's back.
It's brighter and better than ever before.
It's Razzmatazz.
The show packed with the very best from the world of pop.
We have an amazing show for you today. We've got Adam Ant's great new single, Puss in Boots.
And Melanie, one of rock and roll's biggest stars, who's recently been touring Britain, will be knocking us out with her own inimitable style.
The hammer. And we've also got Mike and Bobby from Bucks Fizz, and Looney Lisa will be talking to them.
And Alistair will be having an answer with ace pilot Gary Numan about his new image in his current tour.
OK, you might know them best as Dave and Annie, but our first stars are creating a storm on both sides of the Atlantic. They're going to be right by your side. Here they are! Woo! The Eurythmics! New hip machine. It's in two halves, five questions each half, and our two contestants today representing the boys, we've got Gary, and representing the girls, we've got Amanda. Give them a cheer! Yeah. Right. And we have some amazing new prizes on the hip machine board at...
Yeah.
We have the Razz Chews at...
Yeah.
We have the Razz Tags at...
Yeah.
We have the Razz Blocks at...
Yeah.
We have the Razz Albums at...
Yeah.
We have the Razz at... Oh, well, let's go straight away with the questions. Who's going to go first? Ladies or the guys? Ladies, Amanda? Okay, all right, here we go. Question number one. Name UB40's drink.
Red wine.
Red wine is correct. 68 guns belong to which band?
The Alarm.
Correct. Where will Meatloaf be and when, Amanda?
Midnight at the Lost and Found.
Very good. Gary, there's a secret in the charts which they don't know. Who says so?
Fiona.
Very good. Neck and neck. Prudence's friends are singing about her. Who are they?
Susie and the Banshees.
Susie and the Banshees is correct. Does Howard Jones sing a love song, a new song, or a blue song?
A new song.
A new song is correct. Well done. Blue Monday is a song from which band?
New Order.
Is correct. Big Banana is not the title of the song from Kajagoogoo. What is?
Big Apple.
Big Apple. And the last question in this half. What's a UB40? Is it a form to fill in, a submarine, or a minor road?
Pop
group. Is it a data pop group or a form to fill in? Very good. Where? What is Gary Newman's hobby? Is it Grand Prix, roller skating, or flying aircraft?
Flying aircraft.
Didn't they do well? Nick and Nick, 6 on. Give them a cheer. And Gary, who was that last name you mentioned?
Gary Newman.
Gary Newman has flown here to be with us today. Give him a cheer. Here's Gary. Very, very much indeed for dropping in. Now, you're just nearing the end of a very, very big tour. How's it gone?
Very well. It's been great fun.
Now, your image has changed rather a lot, hasn't it, really? This whole Warriors thing is completely different. Why is that?
Yeah, I've left it off today, but I just got a little bit tired of everything being too prison. I just wanted to put some more theatre into it, more acting into it.
It's all to do with the future and what science fiction. Do you read a lot of science fiction?
Yeah, not so much now as I used to. It's just really an idea of what things might be like should the big war come, what it could be like afterwards.
Does that worry you? I mean, do you think that there might be a big war?
Well, it doesn't worry me. If it comes, it comes.
We don't see the car anymore in the stage show. I used to love that car. It used to come out with all the smoke.
Yeah, no, I've used it too much, guys. I've got some other effects as well.
Now, do you ever feel as if you get real trapped? Because everybody expects everything that Gary Newman does to be so new, so different, time after time after time. That's how you got your reputation. New sound, new stage show. Where do you go?
Yeah. It becomes awkward, so I think periodically you need to take a break from it. You see, I've done a couple of times now. And just go away and get new ideas and come back with something different. You can't stay in the business for a long time and can just keep coming up with new ideas. If you don't get a break from the old ones, you need to get away from what you've done before.
I mean, sometimes some of the newspapers always take like dings at you and go at you. Does that hurt your feelings if ever you pick something up and it says, I don't like Gary Newman, he's useless and all? Does it get to you at all, or does it not bother you anymore?
No, it does. Yes, very much.
So, I mean, what do you feel? Do you feel that that's unfair?
It depends really on what they say. Sometimes it's fair, they genuinely didn't like something. Other times they liked it because they thought it was fashionable to like it. And other times it's just silly and it's very annoying.
It's a rotten lot. Very, very quickly, are we going to see a lot more of you in this country? Are you going to record a lot more? Because you've been away for a while.
Yeah, as soon as this tour's finished, we start the next album. There'll be another tour next year. Not quite as big as this one, but another major one. And then lots of TV things, hopefully.
Gary, thanks very much for coming in. Gary Newman, give him a cheer. Wow. Next star on the show today. Who is it?
It's Melanie with Every Breath of Wine.
Here's Melanie. Give her a cheer. Here she is.
You're right. Ask for it by name. Razzmatazz.
And we've got Mike and Bobby from Bucks. Please along to see us. Yeah! How you doing, fellas? I see that London has going really well for you. So, what can we expect in the future?
We've got a Greatest Hits album coming out later this month with some tracks on which I'm sure everybody will remember. We've also got a couple of new ones, which hopefully will be future hit singles.
I hear that you've been producing and writing the B-sides of your past single. Does this mean that we can expect a Bucks Fizz-produced A-side in the future?
We hope so. On the last album, we produced a couple of tracks which... the record company didn't put out a single, but there was a good chance they were going to go out. But who knows? Very shortly.
Well, I hope they do. I hear you've brought something along very special for us.
Yeah, we've got a couple of albums. Our last album, in fact, signed for the Hit Machine.
Oh, great. Mike and Bobby from Bucks Fizz. Give him a cheer. Come on.
Very exciting second bit of Hit Machine, of course, the big final, and still more exciting prizes to be won at... We have a Razz bag, at... We have a Razz pen, at... We have a Razz jacket, at... We have a Razz brolly, at... We have the Razz top 10 singles. We still have our two contestants, Gary and Amanda. Who's going to win, the boys or the girls? Let's find out. Here we go. Amanda, what is in brackets after the title from Monyaka Go De Yaka?
Go to the Top.
Go to the Top is correct. Name the lady in the song Superstar by Lydia Murdoch.
Billie Jean.
Billie Jean is correct. Pop Goes What? Say Freeze, Amanda.
Hello.
Pop Goes My Love. Gary, Come Back and Stay says whom?
Paul Young.
Very good. The Rocksteady Crew sing a song called what?
Hey, you.
Very good. Hot Streak have their work cut out. What sort of work is it?
Bodywork.
Bodywork, good. What will love do, says David Grant?
Find a way.
Find a way, excellent. And it's neck and neck. Okay, which parent is Genesis song for?
Mama.
Very good. It could all be on this question, or are we going to a tiebreaker? Say, Say, Say is a hit for which duo? Name them.
Paul McCartney and Michael Jackson.
Very good. And it's all on this last question, Gary. David Essex's Paradise Isle is called what?
Tahiti.
Very good indeed. Give him a cheer. Now, we have a tie. So there is a tie for you, a Razz tie, and a tie for you. All right. Now, here's a tiebreaker. Hands on the buzzers, do not push them yet. The tiebreaker question. If you push that buzzer and get this question wrong, get the answer wrong, rather, then all the prizes go to the other contestant. If you get it right, of course, you keep all of the top 10. The tiebreaker question, then, Gary and Amanda. For the winner of our first game, is the lead singer with Dexy's Midnight Runners A, Freddie Dexy, B, Boy George, or C, Kevin Rowland? Amanda.
Kevin Rowland.
Kevin Rowland is the correct answer! That Amanda is this week's chartbuster. Give her a cheer. Amanda, you also get the right, as well as winning the prizes, to introduce our next act on the show today. Now, give him a big build-up because he's a big star, all right? See what you can do.
It's an even bigger chartbuster than me with Puss in Boots, Adam and...
Is that amazing? Adam, there's the order of the bill. Wasn't that a good single? What about that? It's a big hit. Listen. Back by public demand, we now have our amazing tongue-twisting pirate, the amazing Peggy Babcock. And over here you will see her amazing treasure chest. Win the right to unlock and claim its mystery contents. That's what's going to happen when we find out who is Britain's trickiest talker. Having got a brand new tongue twist today, we have Sandra. Give her a cheer. Sandra, are you all raring to go? Here we go. Let's give her a Razz countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
My name is Sarah. I am the Razzest talk and Razzmatazz. More dashing than Duran Duran. Dabby Allen, Mickey Ward, Rock, Quicker Than Culture Club, Snap Allen, Son of Ali, PC Allen, the Police, and Mad Allen, Madness on Razzmatazz. You must know that the square root of 289 is 7 and baby and must be able to state Peggy Babcock 3 times backwards and forwards. But Peggy Babcock, Papa Peggy, Peggy Babcock, Papa Peggy, Peggy Babcock, Papa Peggy. That's it.
I think you did very well and amazing. 21.84 seconds. Give her a cheer. Woo! Adam, would you like to give Sandra the order of the boot there? That's Peggy Babcock's own pirate boot from Adam. And give her a cheer, Sandra. She gets the star. She did so well. If you think you can do even better, here's Peggy herself with the address you can write to. All right, that's the end of the show. Don't forget to join us for the sounds of today and the hits of tomorrow next week.
Until then, take care of yourselves and mind how you go. See ya!
Bye.
Thank you.